Hello everyone, my name is EquilibriumEST, and this is my Witcher 1 gameplay series, episode number 55. So, we are here trying to find the Yishinai priest. However, it seems that he's been driven away. I have no idea how or when or how exactly he will be back here. Nope, no priest still. Let's wait some time then. Right, still no priest. Let's try to sleep half a day. So, goddammit, where are you? Let's try sleeping few hours then. 3 hours? Sounds like a awesome plan. Oh, again? I see those doggone things again. No. I must see the priest again. I don't get it. Just don't get it. And the stupid priest is still not here. Screw it. I'm going to find Berengar. And then I'm going to speak to Julian. And then I'm going to speak to the blacksmith. And then at some random point of time I will come back here. To try to find this stupid priest who is hiding somewhere all the time.
Yeah. Nowhere I can find the friendly Vodian priest?
By the Lady of the Lake's altar on the shore. Sometimes the dragon worshippers drive him away.
I see.
Yeah.
Farewell.
Over the hills and far away. Nah, I can sing actually. I do. But as no one is asking me politely, I'm not gonna do that.
Different? How interesting. Maybe I should meet him.
Yes?
Berengar mentioned you know the legend of Raven.
I know nothing about the legend. I'm more interested in technology. That armor was a breakthrough in armor design. Made possible by advances in metallurgy and smelting.
Very interesting. About the armor.
I can tell you about its qualities.
Good, but remember I know little about metallurgy or smithery.
Three elements remain of Raven's armor. A spaulder, a rearer brace, and a gauntlet. The highest quality iron ores and state-of-the-art technologies were used in its making. Not some useless Temerian smelting pots. The gnomes surpass us technologically by an age. Beneath Mount Carbon, they have blast furnaces and quenching tanks, equipment beyond our reach.
Can you tell me about the armor?
As you wish. The technologies I mention allow for the production of steel both hard and flexible, essentially indestructible. As I said, only parts of the armor remain. To recreate the entire suit, you must find replacement material and someone to assemble the parts.
Any suggestions?
Search crypts where great knights were interred. I heard the counts of the Reuter dynasty wore similar armor. Pieces of that should be reforgeable.
Whoa, that's a bargain. Okay, whatever.
Maybe I should move. Yes?
Farewell.
Right, so Julian, I suppose, is next. Oh yeah, all the interesting people here are dead. Well, not interesting, but let's say that Alina and Selina were pretty interesting characters.
Geralt?
I've taken Berengar's job, decided to handle this problem myself.
We have a serious problem. The underwater city is the source of the village's wealth. A while back, a group of our divers went missing. Later, we found their boat adrift. Inside, it was slaughter, Witcher. Someone cut them to bits. Then we learned the Vodyanoi worship a monster that thirsts for human blood. They make bloody sacrifices to it on the island. If you eliminated that monstrosity...
Have you tried talking to the Vodyanoi?
That makes no sense. They don't understand our language. Anyway, the underwater ruins are of a human city.
Yes, yes.
We're fully entitled to what's there. Kill Dagon. That's the monster's name. The entire village will
worshippers of Dagon.
And
ooh,
I'll
this
give
could
you
be
one
good.
Of my grandfather's diamonds.
I'll do it.
Fuck diamonds.
Dagon emerges from the water.
I want to see the Yeshinai priest.
Fish people bleed too, you know.
I was supposed to slay Dagon.
How is it going with the Vodyanoi?
It's not that simple.
Geralt?
Farewell.
Oh, cool. Maybe as... Oh, yeah. Maybe, as Yeshinai priest is always disappearing because the stupid worshippers of Dagon are chasing him away. If I kill Dagon, maybe there are no worshippers anymore. And maybe this stupid priest will be where he's supposed to be. I hope so. Oh, cool. Just quickly checking if the priest is here. That son of a bitch is here. Come here, ye bastard. What ye be thinking at?
Job. Tell me about this conflict.
We underwater live deep. We lady love, yet not all. Many Dagon love, lady leave. The humans kill. I plead your sword Dagon dis love. I give reward.
So,
I
see. Kill Dagon?
Big blood bovine in village. Dagon for her come. Dis love Dagon. I give reward. Something. Sword? Something wonderful.
You want me to steal the cow and use it to bait Dagon?
Dis love big blood bovine on altar. Dagon come from deep.
I'm supposed to kill it on the altar.
Prefer human sacrifice. Urarlalu.
I'll think about it.
Maybe I should take the quest and just go there and kill his worshippers and kill it and fuck it, let's try it.
I've taken back. I see. You want me to steal? I'm supposed. Alright. Look, I'm no cowherd, so I don't.
Fruits and nuts. Big blood bovine love.
Fruits and nuts?
I'm gonna try Julian's option first. I mean, the mandatory code is to kill Dagon, and both options have the same solution. So, or well, the result is the same, so I would say it works. Should work.
Yes.
Whoa.
Approve?
You sent a troubled soul into the beyond. You revealed Alina to herself with a song.
True.
Yes?
My lady, I spoke with the Vodianoi priest and Julian.
Who is in the right?
It's not about who's right. I want them to reconcile.
Then you must slay Dagon. To do so, bring me objects symbolizing harmony from both communities.
I'll return soon.
You will find clues on the nature of these objects on the statue.
Just in case I'm going to mess everything up very good. Or mess up really bad.
Yes?
M'lady, are these what you wanted?
Try again, Witcher.
Very well. Back to Julian and the priest.
Yes?
M'lady, you look pensive.
Sometimes I see the future, Witcher. Destiny has entangled its threads round a Witcher. His path leads into a dark future, into sadness and pain. I wish to help him survive.
Who is it, m'lady?
You, or Berengar. Speak with him, and may one of you take up Destiny's thread.
I'll speak to Berengar.
Yes?
Farewell.
Okay. Just in case. So, in case I fail and everything wants to kill me, I will load this last save and I will try to solve it the other way. Maybe. Or, as this is a role-playing game, and I'm trying to follow the story here, maybe I will agree with the result as it is. We'll see. Is the dagger exactly? Ooh. Okay. This might end badly. Okay, so attacking worshipper seems to attack him. Oh, for fuck's sake. God, let me... Ah, yeah, he's done. Need to drop something. And okay, it seems that this is time to end episode number 55, so thank you for watching me, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye bye!